Hi, this is Ed Herzog, and today I'm going to show you how to put an intersection inside of another intersection within Elementor, so that you can create a complex layout like the one you see on this page here. So let's jump right into the tutorial. The first thing I want to do in this tutorial is show you the way that you're going to add an intersection to another intersection in Elementor. Then I'll take you through step by step how I created this particular layout so that you have a concrete example to refer to. By the way, let me point out two things real quick. First of all, you might notice that I have all images in my layout design. That's simply the way I decide to set this up. And obviously an image gallery is one particular application of this sort of layout. But you can drop any widget from Elementor or an Elementor add-on that you have access to into this sort of layout. And it doesn't have to be all the same widget either. Again, I used all images here, but you can use combinations of different widgets and put them in here. The other thing I want to mention real quick is that you might notice that these two images here are slightly different lengths, that this one is a little bit longer than this one here. That's simply an artifact of having this visible right now and having limited space over here. If I move this over, you see that they are indeed the same or pretty much the same size. It was hard to get them 100% exact because the original photos weren't the same size, but when I slide that over, you see that they do, in general, appear to be the same size. So you see here that I've added a brand new section to this web page. It's just a single one column section. I'm going to go ahead and drag and drop an intersection right there. So here we have the intersection within the main section. And now here's the problem with Elementor. There's no way to directly add an intersection into another intersection. Let me just show you real quick. So come back over here and pull another intersection, and you see, it will go here in the main section. If I drop it there, now I have two intersections, one there and one here. Let me get rid of that. And I could also put it above the other one. If I drag there, again, it's going to look the same. This time the new one went up here. But it doesn't allow me to take an intersection and drop it into one of these columns there or there that was in the first intersection. So here's what you have to do instead. You have to come over here. Remember, I started off with this single section that had just one column in it. What I need to do is I need to copy the column properties to that section and then paste it right here into this column that came from the intersection. So let me go ahead and do that and show you how this works. So I'm going to come up here and copy that. And then I'm going to go ahead here and paste it. And you see now I have these two new intersections here that are inside of the original intersection. So that's how you do it. But we can keep doing more. Let me show you what else we can do here. Now, if I want to continue to add more intersections within my intersections, it's very simple. And there are a couple different options here. So first of all, you may remember I've already copied the intersection there. So I don't have to copy anything else. One thing I can do is I can paste that again right here. So I paste that. And now I have two intersections within that original intersection. Let me delete that. And I can do the same thing by coming right there to this original, this first one there, and paste it. And again, you see that was the exact same. I have two intersections within that original intersection through these two columns right here. The other thing I can do is this. Again, let me go ahead and delete that. If I paste here, instead of this one there, if I paste right here, so I'm pasting inside of this intersection right here, I now have an intersection that's within an intersection that's within an intersection. And I can keep doing that. From what I understand, nobody's found a limit as to how many of these you can do. So I could keep adding intersections inside of intersections inside of intersections. But of course, at some point, your design is going to get so complicated, so crazy, that it's not going to have any value. So there is a limit to how many of these you really want to do. But just to show you what you can do, right? So you can continue to add intersections inside of this right here. Or again, you could have multiple intersections within this original intersection right here. So a couple of different ways to create your layouts. So that is a basic process for adding an intersection to an intersection. Now let's take a look at how you can create a layout like this one right here using the technique that I just showed you. So let me walk you through the layout here first so you understand what's going on, then I'll show you how to recreate it. So I started with a section in Elementor with two columns. This is the first column here, and this here is the second column. I then added an intersection and put an intersection within that. And then I deleted one of those columns. So that's why there are only three columns here. I deleted one of the columns, but this is an intersection within an intersection right here. Then down here at the bottom, I added a separate intersection that is completely separate from these. This is not an intersection within an intersection. So that's a basic layout that I created here. And then of course I moved things around and made some things wider than others. That way you get a more complex layout than if I had kept all the column widths the same. So to recreate this layout, the first thing I want to do is add a new section with two columns in it. So I'll click here and I'll add a section, two columns. Then I'm going to add an intersection over here. So I'll come over here, drop an intersection in there. And then because I want to have the intersection inside of here, I want to copy this column here, not the one over here, because this doesn't have the intersection properties on it. I want to come over here and copy this one from the main container. And then paste it right there. And I'm going to delete this column here. As I said, I deleted one of the columns. So I'll delete that. And I'm going to add an intersection down below, one that is separate from these intersections up here. So now I have the basic layout of what I created here, but I obviously still have to add the content and do a little designing to it. So let me go ahead and do that. I'll start by adding the photos. So let me first add the image widget. So I'll drag and drop these. There's a second one down underneath that one. One there. One here. Another one here. There's one that comes right underneath those two. That's part of the same column, but it's not part of the intersection. One right there. And finally, another image right there. So now we have the image widgets. Now I need to add the actual images. So I'll click right there and then choose my image. And I already have all those images inside of my media library in WordPress. This was the first one on the upper left-hand side. I'm not going to go through and do every single one of these on the camera because I don't think you want to see me add each individual image, but I'll do the first one here. Just click there and then insert media. And there you go. And then I'll do the rest of these off camera. So now I have the basic design layout and also have the content added, but I obviously need to make some design tweaks so that this here looks the same as this here on the bottom. So the first thing I want to do is change the column widths. So this here I have set at 34%, and this here I have no idea why I went with a number so specific, but this is 42.4%. So this should now be the same in terms of column widths, but obviously there's still work to do. Now the next step is, you see, if I hover over here on each of the columns, you're going to see that I have some extra spacing, some extra padding there. So I'm going to go into each of the columns and add a padding of 0. So let me go ahead and do that. And I need to get these ones here that are within the intersection as well. Okay, so I've gotten rid of all that padding that was within the columns. So we're making progress, but we still have a little bit more work to do. So next up, I want to get rid of the space between these two widgets here that are within the same column. So I'm going to click here on the column settings and put in 0 for widget space. And then I want to change the height of a couple of the photos so that everything aligns properly. So for the waterfall, I'm going to put in a height of 405 pixels. And for this tree here, I'm going to put in a height of 400 pixels. So now we have all these images pretty much kind of pasted together, but we obviously want some spacing. As you see, I have spacing here. So what I want to do now is add within each image a padding of 5. So come here and go through and put in 5 for each of these. Again, I'm going to do most of this off screen because I don't think you want to see me do this for each photo, but that is what I'm going to do to finish this up. So I added the padding of 5 to each of these images here, and you see, voila, that I've recreated up here what I started with down here. Same settings, same alignment, using that intersection within an intersection trick. So that is how you use an intersection within an intersection to create a complex layout within Elementor. If you have any questions or comments about this, please let me know. Also, if you want my personal help with Elementor, please visit the Elementor Services website, where I offer a variety of services such as learning how to use Elementor, maintaining your Elementor website, fixing problems on Elementor, speeding up your Elementor website, updating your WordPress website that is not on Elementor to Elementor, and finally, moving a website that is on Wix or Squarespace to Elementor. Finally, while what I showed you today does not require Elementor Pro, if you do choose to upgrade to Elementor Pro, there will be a link in the description below that will take you directly to the Elementor website. So, I hope you found this tutorial helpful, and I hope you have a great day. Bye.